What I'd like to do is capture a moment, and it's a beautiful moment, and that's what I would like to put on my wall.
What's fun about this is that I'm trying to shoot a story. I'm not really doing a typical post modeling shots, and also I don't have to have it perfect. It's more about candid.
Some of the biggest sellers that I do have are my accident scenes. And with my long lens, I usually never get hassled by the police or anything like that.
You know, advertising to me is pop art. It's the most powerful medium in the world, you know? Today, this shoot is just simply for me to photograph beauty. I find these so incredibly beautiful. And that's a duality that I also like, is the violence underneath all that beauty. Book of things that I've always wanted to photograph, just for the sake of photographing it, not for money, just simply for the love of it. And I'm really happy that I'm able to do that right now. I normally photograph a lot of people and product. I shoot everything, really. A photograph needs to work in this area where it's look, think, and feel, you know? Before you can feel the intended message of an image, it's got to be intriguing enough for you to look at it, first of all. And if it's intriguing enough for you to look at it, then it forces you to think about it for a moment. And if you can walk away still feeling that image, then you've succeeded as a photographer, because you've just created resonance in an image. I just love taking pictures. It's that simple. I feel very lucky, and to actually get paid for it is just bonus. Photography is actually sounds bizarre, kind of weird, but it was a dream. And it basically showed me all the steps I had to take to get to where I am now. And I'm pretty happy to say that it played out almost exactly. So whether photography chose me or I chose photography, I don't know. I've been very fortunate to have the opportunity to work with various people like Nissan, Adidas, Nike. I'm more into trying to get a great image at that moment, that day, than, you know, the blingness of, say, you're working for Nike, you know? Or you're working for Nissan or Ford. Wow. It's a little trickier than I thought because the depth of field issues with the macro. And I just want it really simple and really clean. I want nothing to distract you from the texture and the color of these fish. And their actual shape is quite amazing. That iridescent quality is so beautiful. It's tough work, and you really got to work hard to get things together sometimes. But the bottom line is, you know, a client is entrusted, an art director has trusted you to do a job for him, and it's important. And you know, you can either sit there and bitch and complain and whine about this is not right or that's not right, or you can just deal with it and make it right. And that's essentially why you get hired as a photographer, is to make it right. In this day and age of Photoshop, you know, you can do so many things. Photoshop is just simply a tool to make something better. It doesn't necessarily mean that Photoshop is gonna make your image great. Crap in, crap out. I'm a fan of Photoshop, though, to be honest with you. For me, it's a moment when you're shooting, you know when you got the shot, right? You know. So essentially, even with quoting, you're essentially doing the photograph in your mind. So you've already done the job long before you've even begun the job. So you anticipate all the things that you're gonna be going through, and you systematically go through the entire shoot. And the moment, it's a beautiful feeling, really, because the moment you, bam, that instant that you get that image and you know that's the right image, it's like, out the park. If you treat each job as your last, you know, and make it like the first time, you know, and you'll do okay, you know. I think the moment you get to the point where you become this old hat where, you know, oh, I've been there, done that, you know, you're done, you know. There's still a lot more that I haven't, although I may have done a lot of things already, there's still so many more things that I have not done. So, in time, hopefully I can do as many of them as possible. So, as for what I like to shoot, I like everything. I like people, I like product, I like animals, I like leaves, I like texture, color, and just the way the light affects things. So it could be just about anything. Just about anything. I don't shoot food, though. Or I have not done food yet. You know, a friend of mine said to me, you know, it's amazing, I'm a lawyer. I can go to work and work, but you can't separate you, Patrick Nichols, from photography. It's essentially part of you. You're one. You can't say, oh, I'm gonna just not work, because then you're not gonna be yourself, because you are one with what you do, you know? And I've never thought of photography as work. It is a passion. It's fun. You know, photography's been really kind to me. I've never worked a day in my life. Wow, that one's beautiful.
I have a vision most of the time, actually, very strange vision. When I'm driving a car and I put very loud music, I suddenly see all the pictures and I see the storyboards and I see all these crazy things. And in that moment, I just want to grab my camera and shoot. My name is Zdenka Micka, and I was born in a small town in the Czech Republic. And I did a lot of modeling. I was in the industry for 16 years, and now I'm a photographer, 3.5 years, and I like it much, like, I really like it better than being in front of a camera. What really changed my career, honestly, it was Playboy. When I landed on the front cover, I immediately had open door to anything I wanted. It was a lot of fun. I can't even say more. It was an amazing year for me. Ended up as a photographer is very actually interesting story. It was by an accident. I went to Thailand to do a little photo shoot for a magazine. It was right after the tsunami. It was a pretty dangerous shoot, but I had so much fun. And the photographer was carrying too many bags, and I felt I really need to help him. The other girls were, you know, a little bit the kind of like prima donnas, I would say, but a very nice way. And so I kept carrying all these things, and I was just helping him so much, and he said, hey, you should shoot. So I thought about the idea, and a friend of mine lent me his camera for a week, and I did a shoot, and it turned out just spectacular. And then I bought a camera, and I started shooting. Today, what I'm doing, I'm not really using anything complicated. I'm just shooting with a flash straight up to the ceiling, and I'm using other lights. I'm doing a whole bunch of combinations, so the story is not boring. The people, the viewers, they will get about 35 to 20 to 50 shots in the whole story, so I wanted to make sure it's very colorful, very different. They are not bored to look at it. Okay, ladies, there you go. Show me the face. Good. Awesome. Very good. A little bit separate, yeah, that's fine. One more. Okay, perfect. Especially as a photographer, I have very wide range because I get bored very easily and I need challenge all the times. So mostly I'm shooting stock photography because that gives me 100% creativity and 100% control of what I want to shoot. I also do a lot of glamour shots, makeovers. I also shoot panorama, all our virtual tour. I do interiors, exteriors, and then just fun stuff, whatever I feel like. I'm sometimes amazed what I come up with, and it's on the go. Never planned. One day you might just simply open the door and I might be facing you. Very simply because I work for real estate and I shoot many homes and very beautiful locations, even offices and industries for basically real estate panorama shoots. And last visit I was in Czechoslovakia, back home in Czech Republic, and I took some beautiful shots of my hometown, Olomouc. I was just walking through beautiful streets and I was impressed and just amazed by the houses. We had flooding a few years ago and now they are all repaired and they look so gorgeous. I hate planning. So when I get to the shoot, I get really excited when I'm seeing that I'm getting something new. I also don't like repetitions. I don't like doing my lights always the same. I love to play with them. I just like to come up with different moods, different lighting systems, and that gives me the rush. If I can come up with something new, but nobody else has. That's perfect. And just like really work it a little bit. That's good. Excellent. Love that shot. One more. Pull it together. Perfect. When I'm done with these images, I'm planning to post them up on my upcoming magazine and you will be able to visit. And perfect, okay. I definitely work better with female models just because I can show them how they are supposed to pose. Sometimes just to tell them is not enough, and if I can just go there, pose for them a little bit, show them, then they do perfect results. Also, the female models, they tell me they feel much more comfortable with me as of being female. So I guess it's an advantage. I cannot tell you if it's natural for a model to become a photographer. As advice for models, I would say if you want to try it, get ready. You will need a lot of muscle. It's nothing glamorous at all.
It's always challenging to come down here and shoot Niagara a little bit differently, a little bit in a way that no one's ever captured it before. Profession would be when they grew up, and like all the guys that put Playboy photographer, I always thought that was cool. Actually, for me, I wanted to be a professional bowler, but I'm not sure, you know, what really led me to shooting, other than, you know, picking up a camera and just enjoying it so much. Shot in about 42 countries worldwide, and this is still one of my favorite places on earth to shoot. The reason why I like coming down along the gorge here is that most of the tourists are all up top, and this is where, you know, the common folk never get to. And it also gives you a chance to get some really great images that no one else has ever captured. I've never been down here in the winter time. Looks a lot different. Hey, I found a spot. We can go down this way. Just watch your step. It's going to be very slippery. One thing about photography, you never get a great understanding of how cold it is, but up top of the gorge is like minus 26 with the wind chill right now. You know, what's incredible about this location, and I've been here in the summer, I've been here in the fall, and I've been here at night. I've never been here in winter, but the place, I mean, it's constantly changing. And even though there are millions of photos taken of Niagara Falls every year, it's always challenging to come down here and shoot Niagara a little bit differently, a little bit in a way that no one's ever captured it before. I started shooting micro stock photography, meaning that you were able to put a gallery online and people were able to purchase your images for, you know, like a dollar a shot. You probably see stock photography all the time. You just don't realize that that picture of the little girl in the park blowing bubbles was shot by someone and purchased by another person to use in their ad. I always envied musicians that penned famous songs and received royalties from that moment of creativity. And this is probably the closest I'm ever going to get to collecting a royalty in that manner, where my shots are online 24/7, and while I'm out shooting other images, my images online are making money and I can go out and buy new gear. Some of the biggest sellers that I do have are my accident scenes. I'm always carrying my camera with me, and if I'm driving and I come across an accident, I'm like the first guy out, and with my long lens, I usually never get hassled by the police or anything like that, but they happen to be probably the biggest sellers that I have online right now. It's an incredible feeling that you get when you're down here. I mean, the falls are about 168 feet high, and yet when you're down here along the river, I mean, you feel very small. Another crazy thing about this place is that last century, there was a race between Thomas Edison and Nikola Tesla to create, you know, basically the first electricity generating stations in the world. And they thought by harnessing the water of the falls, they could probably sent enough power to every industry in North America at the time, which is just phenomenal. And
for those who are keeping track, it wasn't Edison that actually won. It was Tesla who came up with the 60-cycle system, which we use in North America. Electricity as we know it was born right here. Being a professional videographer has allowed me to travel around the world, and recently I had the opportunity to shoot in Shanghai a few times. And I mean, it is an incredible city. It is just astounding how dense the population is, and they've basically transcended the whole city into the new millennium by creating all of these unbelievable buildings. There's no other place on Earth right now that could compare to Shanghai. Well, maybe Dubai, but I always take my still camera along and whenever possible, grab some photos. But I'm just so fortunate to be able to travel on someone else's tab and see the world and cultures and meet some incredible people. I love shooting motorsports. I love shooting vehicles of all kinds, whether it be motocross, snowmobiling. Another event that takes place near where I live annually is like a mud bog. And the locals get together for a couple times during the year. They bring contraptions that they've built. They bring dad's truck, their jeeps or whatever, and they come and they play in the mud for the day. And mud, when it's thrown up and about, takes on a whole new life of its own when it's frozen during that fraction of a second. That I've been shooting for about the last 6 years now is a motorcycle gathering that always happens on Friday the 13th. Everyone gathers with their motorcycles and gets together, and the camaraderie and the amount of people that infest this little community for the one day is amazing. And I really enjoy getting out and about and shooting that, because as well, you never know what you're gonna find. People think that because I carry this big high-definition camera around on my shoulder that I'm a technician, and I always kind of hated that because it made me sound like I was an electronic engineer. But I would have to say that, you know, because there's so much creativity that goes into it, yet there is a technical aspect to shooting, that I'm a creatician. I'm just so fortunate to have a job that I truly enjoy. Getting up in the morning, I never know where I'm gonna be, who I'm gonna meet, what the subject matter is going to be. And as I tell most people, because I get paid to watch, it sure beats working for a living. I think that's enough Niagara for one day. That's a wrap, baby. ¶¶